that even on a really bright sunny day. And of course, if you are in a darkened room, at least you can just sort of knock it down a bit. It'll be ever so slightly illuminated, so you can read the text quite clearly, and hopefully it won't disturb anyone else who's, for instance, passed out in bed next to you, etc. And of course, it's the usual Amazon anti-reflective panel. So as you can see that, even with bright reflection shining off the screen, still can make out what is going on pretty easily. And if you are struggling again, as I say, it could boost up that brightness, and that'll certainly take care of that, no worries. Doesn't appear to be any auto adjustment, however, it is all just manual adjustments. You'll have to go into the settings and play around with it every time you want to change it. And when you're actually in a book, of course, you get loads of different features. Let's just get across a full tutorial that actually takes you through all of these features. You can play around here at the bottom. You can quickly zip between pages or different chapters. Very good way of finding a specific part in the book. You do, of course, have full bookmarking facilities and everything as well, so you can get back to exactly where you want to go to later on. And the good news is that your book position is synced throughout all of your Kindle devices and everything, so if you do occasionally read on a tablet or a phone or something as well, your favourite features are back on board as well, like the vocabulary building, full dictionary support, of course, so if there's a big word in there that you don't understand, such as subsequently, just give it a little tap, and as you can see, you get a full dictionary definition, and you can also look it up on the likes of Wikipedia, stuff like that too. If you are going to be enjoying a bit of audible audiobook action as well, then of course you can't just play it directly through the Kindle because there's no speakers or anything on here, so that won't do anything. What you'll need to do is you'll need to connect a Bluetooth device. If you've got some Bluetooth headphones or Bluetooth speaker, you can just scan for it using the Kindle, get connected, you can enjoy your audible books, which is a nice little feature. And I also really like the family sharing as well, so if you and your wife, kids, all get involved on the Kindle library, then you can share each other's books. You might notice that some of these books are quite blatantly mine, and some of them are quite blatantly not. As for the battery life, I reckon your new Kindle 2019 edition will probably last you a couple of weeks on a single charge, depending on how much you actually use it. Obviously, that's sort of based on an hour or so of reading on the commute. Last of all, let's just smash open this official fabric cover for the Kindle. And yeah, Kindle devices are generally pretty frickin' hardy, so you can literally throw them across the room, drop them onto concrete, and they're generally absolutely fine. They are very hardy, and the glass screen or anything like that that you need to worry about. But the same, if you are worried about your Kindle getting damaged or anything like that, you can slap on one of the official covers. I quite like this fabric finish. It adds a nice bit of texture to it. It makes it feel a bit more premium than the device actually is. As you can see there, still obviously got full access to the charging port, the power button, so you've got those if you need to. And of course, one of the great things about the official covers is it does put the Kindle to sleep when you close it up, so you don't even need to bother touching that power button. And when you flip it open, boom, just wakes back up again. Does add a fair bit of girth, unfortunately, to the Kindle, as you can slap down below in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest tech as well. Cheers, everyone. Love you!
집에서 놀고 놀으라고 지금 놀게 없으니까 내가 잠깐만요.